Welcome to Water Balance of River Basins. My name is Andreas de Jong. In today's video, I would like to introduce you to snow monitoring in river basins. We'll talk about two methods. Firstly, the snow water equivalent methods, and secondly, the snow covered area method. I'll tell you how the methods work and what you should be careful of using real examples from Afghanistan. Precipitation is the main input to the water balance, and in the previous video, I showed you how to download the free CHIRPS precipitation dataset for a catchment. If the precipitation falls as rain, it will end up in a stream or a river sooner or later. If it's cold and the precipitation falls as snow, it's a different story. Here's a picture of the beautiful Khujand region of Tajikistan. As long as it's cold enough, the snow stays frozen and will start to accumulate. My greetings to Faizuddin and all my friends in Tajikistan if you're watching. Some of the snow will evaporate directly to the atmosphere without melting by a process called sublimation. But most of it will eventually melt and contribute to surface runoff. You can think of the snow-covered mountains as the frozen water towers of the region, which accumulate water in the form of snow during the winter and then release it as meltwater to downstream users during the spring and early summer flood season. Here you can see the mighty Vakhsh River in Tajikistan. The amount of water available during the flood season is really important, as it is needed for irrigation to grow rice and other crops. In a drought year, there's not enough water available and many crops will fail. While in a flood year, there's too much water available. It will inundate the low-lying areas and can cause significant flood damage. For water resources planners, it is really important to know how much snow is accumulated in the mountains at the end of winter, so that they can predict how this translates into water available for downstream users during the irrigation season. One way is to go and have a look in the mountains and measure how much snow there is in different places. This is a traditional approach that has been used for hundreds of years by the Mihrabs of Afghanistan. Getting around the mountains takes a lot of time. You could have a look from a plane or helicopter, but that is also quite expensive. So how do we find out how much snow there is? The first method is snow water equivalent, often abbreviated as SWE or SWE. The snow water equivalent is defined as the liquid water equivalent of the snowpack, expressed in terms of depth. Basically, it is the amount of water that will be released from the snowpack when it melts. Let's say that we have a cylinder full of snow and the temperature starts to rise above the freezing point. The snow will start to melt until all the snow has turned into water. The depth of this water is called a snow water equivalent, and we can express it in meters over the land surface. If we take a catchment, say upstream of a dam, and we know the snow water equivalent over the catchment, then we can calculate the snow water volume. All we need to do is to multiply the average snow water equivalent of the catchment by its area. The snow water volume over the catchment is expressed in MCM, which stands for million cubic meters. To calculate the snow water equivalent is quite complicated, and it requires a lot of different remote sensing inputs and hydrological models which need to be calibrated with ground data. For Central Asia, I recommend the snow water equivalent data provided by the FLDAS project. You can access the snow products at the USGS FuseNet data portal. I'll leave a link in the description below this video and also show you how to do it in the next video. Here is a map of the snow water equivalent over Central Asia on March 15, 2019, and a more detailed map of the snow water equivalent over Afghanistan on the same date. We can also access monthly summaries of the data using the Google Earth engine. Let's have a look at the Central Asia region. With the snow water equivalent for March 2019, let's add the Salma Dam catchment in Western Afghanistan. We can zoom in, and you can see how the snow water equivalent varies over the mountains. Pixel resolution here is 0.1 degrees, which is about 10 kilometers. There was a lot of water stored as snow over the catchment during March 2019, compared with March 2021. The snow water equivalent is a really powerful tool for water resources planners, as it allows us to quantify how much water is stored as snow for any catchment. Here's a chart of the Salma Dam catchment, and you can see how the snow water volume changes over the year. The average snow water volume of the basin is shown by the dotted blue line. The green line shows the 2019 water year, a very wet year. Compare it with the brown line, which is the 2021 water year. 2021 is definitely a drought year, but note that there have been even worse years in the past. So this is a really cool tool for water resources planners. There is, however, one thing to keep in mind. To be really confident about snow water equivalent data, we need calibration from ground stations. Here's an example from the western United States. All the dots on this map are the location of the snow water monitoring stations. There are literally hundreds of them. So what do we do if we don't have an advanced snow monitoring network? How do we know if this snow water volume anomaly plot for the Salma Dam catchment is real or not? If we don't have real data with which to calibrate our models, the RERO principle applies. RERO stands for rubbish in, rubbish out. Let me tell you a quick story from the Panjama River Basin in northern Afghanistan. Yes, that's me standing on an old Soviet tank parked in the middle of a wheat field. In April 2011, I flew to Kunduz. Apparently, the FuseNet snow water model had predicted a massive flood that year. As I looked out of the window, I did not think that there was that much snow around. At the end of March 2011, the model predicted about 47 cubic kilometers of snow water volume over the Panjama River Basin. 2009 had been a big flood year, and the snow water volume in that year had only been about 32 cubic kilometers. Were we heading for the mother of all floods, 50% higher than in 2009, which had already caused a lot of damage? What should we tell the farmers? The MODIS satellite images of the 2 years looked quite similar, and there was no evidence that 2011, shown here on the right, had a lot more snow than 2009, shown on the left. We also checked the GPCC winter precipitation data over Afghanistan. It's a much coarser grid, but you can clearly see that there was much more precipitation in 2009, shown on the left, than 2011, shown on the right. We also checked the winter rain and snow thickness data from Afghan ground stations. The 2009 data is plotted on the x-axis and 2011 on the y-axis. Clearly, 2011 had received much less precipitation than 2009, or the data points would have plotted above the blue line representing a 1-in-1 slope. In fact, 2011 received only about 50 to 60% of the 2009 precipitation. The moral of the story is, always check your data, especially if it is coming out of a complicated model. In this case, there had been a malfunction of the TRMM satellite, which resulted in an exaggerated precipitation estimate. The USGS was aware of it, and they stopped publishing data until the problem was fixed. Luckily, there's a second method for monitoring snow, which is much less complicated. It is the snow-covered area method, and it's actually one of the tools used to check the results of the snow water equivalent method. Snow-covered area is defined as the amount of land covered by snow at any given time. Here's a view from my hotel room showing a bit of snow cover building up over the city of Tashkent in Uzbekistan. Let's go back to our map of snow water equivalent of the Salma Dam catchment using data from Google Earth Engine. Note that the pixel resolution is about 10 kilometers. Here's the same area showing the snow covered area from MODIS. There's much more detail here, as MODIS has a nominal resolution of 500 by 500 meters. 2019 was a very wet year, with plenty of water available for irrigation during the flood season. Compare it with a snow-covered area in March 2021. Yes, this year is a drought year, but we already knew that in March just by looking at the snow-covered area. We can measure how the snow-covered area of a catchment changes over time, and then see how the current year compares to the past 20 years. Although it does not give us an exact snow water volume for the catchment, we can compare it with previous years, so we can see if we're heading for an average, a wet, or a dry year. I'll show you how to analyze the snow-covered area for catchment in the next video using free MODIS data and one of my Excel templates. Thank you so much for your attention. I hope that you found this video interesting and useful. If you have any questions, please leave a comment in the description below. I hope to see you on the next video.